Not only interested, I did try out.
Oh.
But then again, it hits your ego. La.
You're mixing around with the young girls. Oh, shut up, like you.
Not real.
I think
for real.
Probably real.
I see him always make people laugh.
我觉得他是演喜剧比较多.
Was he in police and
in the news? La. He's like this mud rock or something, right?
I usually see him in Surya advertisement.
If he took on a serious role, I wouldn't believe him because he's a funny guy.
I think I would like to see him in like a horror movie. I think it would be quite funny.
My impression, I don't see him on TV that people now, so maybe he is retiring soon.
No need to retire, la. He knows everything. Also, he can still can work.
So guys, what are your impressions of our guest today?
My impression of him is that he's super duper funny. Like everyone mentioned his name, right? They start giggling already.
Yeah, but in real life, he's also super funny.
I feel like he's the guy who's probably very popular with the machiks.
Yeah. He's actually a machik killer.
Machik killer.
So right now, we're gonna dig deeper and find out whether these impressions are real or not. So Suhaimi is officially half a century old now, and he seriously does not look it at all. So, what's your secret?
Half a century! Oh my goodness! It's like, wow, masterpiece. You just have to remain happy because everything is in the mind. So when you remain happy, you look at life a bit more positively, then of course things around you are much more beautiful. Yeah, so it resonates in the way you think and the way you look.
After spending several decades in the spotlight, Suhaimi is finally ready to bow out from the showbiz industry.
I don't think so.
Real or not?
I don't think it's real. I mean, I think you have all this energy left.
To another still... half a century to go.
Yeah. Well, half a century.
I'm a 100-year-old man. Welcome to the show. When we're much younger, we begin to think like, oh, when I want to work, I want to work like this and this and then get paid and stuff like that. But then we realize that as we grow older, then we start to understand about life. Then we realize that actually work today, as it becomes more clearer, work is something that you love to do.
Yeah, for sure.
So when I entered into the showbiz, I didn't know, I came in by accident. I was a shy boy when I was in school.
How do you get a role?
I think the turning point in my life was in secondary three, when my teacher actually assigned me to do a Teacher's Day performance. Mm. For me, I said, I want to commit suicide really. Yeah, because I really had a couple of friends. I was very shy boy. I'm not expressive. I had a... two other friends to help me out. And I said, well, let's do a simple sketch and then just get it over and done with. So you become Michael Jackson. I said, why me? Why I become Michael Jackson? Why? I mean, I have to move, I have to dance. I cannot do that, man. To cut the story short, it's like, okay, next to my school, it was Montfort School in the old place, in the 1980s, next to the school was actually a whole entire land of cemetery. The guy asked me the first question, so I asked you, you just answer, and that's it. And we're over and done with the Teacher's Day concert. Okay, can, on. So he asked, why do you come out with a Thriller album? I'm supposed to answer something else and I forgot the line. So I like panic. Now the whole entire school is looking at me. So I had no idea, but I turn around and say, I did the Thriller album for these people down there. Then the whole school laughed. I just had to say something. Then that's when I realized, hey, I can make people laugh. Yeah, so that brought me out of the closet. If somebody asked me, so what do you do for a living, right? So I say, the one that I started since Sex 3, then make people laugh.
That's how your career
started.
Having
fun.
Yeah.
And then I say, you call this work? This is not even work. If it is not work, how can you ever retire from this? Right?
Oh, that's
it's
deep.
Fun.
That's deep.
It's amazing. Okay. This is a whole entire life.
I also cannot really see myself stopping. Like
this?
Yeah. Maybe at like 70 or 80 when we are really, really physically tired. It's always something that keep ourselves active.
And you probably will grow, and according to the age, you know, your taste buds begin to change.
Yeah.
When you reach a certain age, let's say 40, you begin to sing some songs which were popular in 1970s.
The moment you started humming this subconsciously, you're
like,
I got old.
Yeah, got old. You got old, and the best thing is, you're not the only one, because the audience also grow old. There's always be a market for you.
Yeah. Oh my God,
they will always be good, they grow old with you.
In Singapore, like, a lot of people are not entertainers and they are all working 9 to 5 and everything.
Yeah,
and they have retirement ages.
Right now, they are increasing the retirement age gradually from 62 to 65. So
65.
Keep on grinding, my man.
Yeah, and then the re-employment age will be increased from 67 to 70.
But even approaching retirement, I think we also have a lot of schemes that can help us, definitely.
Oh yeah, for sure. A lot of people worry about like when you're retired, that you don't have enough income.
Yeah.
But thankfully, the government has implemented stuff like silver housing bonus.
Silver housing bonus?
Silver housing bonus, so it's easier for you to like, if you're retired, you can buy you can still get a house and a place to live, and the lease buyback scheme. So if let's say you want to like mortgage off your house, you can sell it back, and ta-da, money comes back.
And then for the older workers, like in 2021, the CPF contributions rates will increase also.
So as an employer, you have to put more money into that CPF account.
Yeah.
That's the part where you actually plant the seed, you know, when you are that energetic period. So when you plant your seed, what I mean is like when you are 50, you plant it at the age of 30. That's what you want to be or what you want to do when you grow older. So that's how you plan for retirement. So you want to be a little bit more active, you start to change your activity, do things that you like at the age of 30 because you're in command. You still have the energy and anger. So by the time you're 50, you're a little bit slow, a bit more lesser energy. But you see, what you invested, it grew into a tree. So you just enjoy the fruits of the tree when you're 50 and then just like glide through when you're 60. Reaching towards the retirement, of course, you need to be number one. I think we do have a proactive government. I must admit that they are quite proactive in helping out. But then again, we have to be self-sufficient in ourselves. Because if you are a person who takes care of your health, the doctor is just assisting you.
Yeah.
So in terms of finance, in terms of experience, in terms of your own mental state, you have to be self-sufficient, whether it's government or any other bodies that render some help. The help is just a little booster to whatever that you are already in. That's what retirement is all about to me.
So seniors who belong to the Merdeka or Pioneer generations will also be eligible for additional benefits that help to defray their healthcare costs.
Give me more, give me more, want some more, want some more.
They have all these cool things like the CHAS cards.
Yeah.
And they have schemes that help with like really cheap screening.
It's pretty good. I mean, it's like when you reach a certain age and suddenly you get all these presents, right?
Yeah.
It's like, oh, you remember me. It's the thoughts that counts. We always want the best present. But a present is always a present. Take it, man.
Yeah.
Because I think sometimes Singaporeans, you give, you complain, you don't give, you complain.
Right? Yeah.
But then I think if you travel around more, look around the world, and then you begin to appreciate just the thought of it. You know, some people say, I want to migrate, I want to go stay somewhere else. But then again, you know how many people actually want to become Singaporean?
Hey, yeah, man.
Low crime rate.
The grass is always greener on the other side.
Yeah, exactly.
No, it's just because that I've seen places, I've seen things, you know, I've seen like how we can walk around 3 a.m. in the morning. These are small little things that maybe we take for granted, including the packages. So take it, use it.
You know, speaking of people like Suhaimi who have like taken an active step towards like bettering themselves, learning some skills, staying engaged, the government has also these active aging programs that are organized to help keep seniors active, healthy, and engaged. There are these classes like Zumba, you know,
the old people playground.
Yes, they have that. They have cooking classes, and even my favorite, karaoke.
But not just only that, they also have like increased efforts to make the road safer for seniors. They call it Silver Zone.
So these Silver Zones are actually designed with customized safety features. Mm-hmm. You know, so it will remind motorists to be very mindful of the old people as they're crossing the road.
Or I thought like the old people will like knock down trucks. Or
then there's Danger Zone.
Those are the rioting. Sorry.
But would you be interested in like Zumba and all that?
Not only interested, I did try out.
How is it?
Maybe he's the Zumba instructor.
He's really
good. No. I'm the zombie. Zumba. It's quite fun. I mean, some instructors are a bit more aggressive. So you get like really punchy, tired after the
It really work you up.
But then Zumba is a bit more toned down, relaxed.
Right.
But then again, it hits your ego.
Because
90% all women. You know? So like Zumba, then you go Zumba. You're mixing around with the young girls. Shut up.
Next up. So Suhaimi's success as a comedian has reduced him to little more than a stereotype. Is this real or not?
This is loaded.
This is a loaded question.
When people meet you, they always expect you to be very bubbly, very high energy.
Yeah, I was parking my car in a multi-story car park, and then I was just like thinking of something. As I walk, then there's somebody who actually walked on my right side, you know, passed by. And then the next 2 days, it just happened so to be a neighbor's friend. Mm. And this is the comment when he said to a neighbor, "Oh, you got very stuck up."
What?
I was like, what? Yeah, maybe you're right. Because they expect me to like, you know, park my car. And they say, like, "Hey, I'm looking my car." But I think it's not really stereotype. I think the image form.
Right.
Because
they
believe that you are in that happy world.
Yeah
I'm very happy, but I'm not that happy every second.
24/7,
you
know? Yeah.
Have you ever done a serious role in your career?
Oh yes, I think in the movie long, long time ago, that was the first time that I actually cried in a scene. When Jack Neo directed the movie, he came up to me after that and he said, "Hey, you extremist. What do you mean extremist? You make people laugh and then you switch over to make people cry. So he called me the extreme. Oh, okay, I don't mind if that
is the topic. Yeah, that's borderline racist.
Okay, okay, you gotta be careful what you say, man.
Okay. In the best way, extreme is the best way. So Suhaimi is living proof that age is just a number, especially when it comes to his prolific showbiz career. Is this real or not?
I must say that times have changed. Social media has brought a different ball game to the whole media world. When we talk about social media itself, it's a different rule, certain, but it's the same thing. It's just evolving into a social media. The problem with people of my age, you know.
Okay.
I said, why don't you just like pick up your phone and then learn something to edit and then you can even shoot. No lah, no time lah. This is how young people wanna. See, so there are in their camp who say these are young people stuff. And then the young ones say these are old school.
Yeah.
Yeah. To me, it's like this is a new toy.
Do you feel at your age, right? Does your opportunities limit because of that?
Because of my age. Like I said earlier on, that when you age, the audience grew with you. But now, as the media evolve, I also got to evolve. So there's abundance of opportunity right here, but not many people can actually recognize that.
So now we are in 2020, what are your plans?
To socialize more.
Really?
I'm excited with social media, actually.
Yeah?
I'm going full throttle on social media by 2020. The younger ones, like yourself, and all that, you've been embracing it, right? So then I find like, hey, I'm missing out on the playground now. So I want to have fun too. And then it comes to the point where I realize that 2020 is a good year to do this because I think I maturely understood how social media is. Because I would say, not once, I would say twice. 50 is the new 2020.
Best of luck with that, Suhaimi. Yeah.
All right, guys, so after our conversation with Suhaimi today, what are your impressions of him?
He feels like the uncle I never had.
He's an old wise sage. I could monetize him by selling him as a lecture package.
Provide TED Talks.
Provide TED Talks. I just bring him to all the universities in Singapore, sell them a 6-course package, and then make a ton of money.
Wow, I can't believe you'll just make use of him, man.
Hey, no, man, dude, you heard the retirement age got increased, right? So I'm trying to just like utilize it to his
Yeah, expand your portfolio.
Expand the portfolio, dude.
Yeah, anyway, today, a lot of things he shared actually resonate with us a lot, especially since we are in the entertainment industry. And he's been doing it for 30 years. That's longevity, which I think is very, very hard to achieve, especially in industry like ours. So we have come to the end of today's episode and we will see you next time for
Real or Not.
Bye.
Nobody wants to be the bad guy in Singapore.
I want.
Right?
It's okay.
Yeah, there are still some expectations. And if they choose acting,
like, I won't stop them, but.